In this video, we're going to go through a few examples of identifying curves in 3-space. So we'll take a look at the equation, talk about how we might identify it, and then look at a 3-dimensional plot. So let's talk about first how to identify a curve. There's some of the stuff we want to look at in order to figure out what it might be. One trick is to look at it in 2 dimensions. We can also look for any symmetry present in the equation that we would expect to see in the graph. We could also look for something called radial symmetry. So radial symmetry is best described by looking at a function that has it. So consider a function of the form f of xy equals e to the negative x squared plus y squared. And you see its graph there on the right. We could actually rewrite this as e equals negative r squared. So radial symmetry is a graph that has the same function value at all points on that circle. And you'll recognize it because it'll have an x squared plus y squared piece in it. This is known as circular or radial symmetry. We can also relate it to similar shapes or familiar shapes or graphs that we've even seen before. So let's try a few. So our first one will be z equals 3. Let's think about what this looks like. It has all its points that have a z-coordinate of 3. In 2 dimensions, it's going to look like a line. For instance, in the xz plane, it's going to look like the following. In the yz plane, it looks pretty similar. So the big question is, what will this thing look like in 3 dimensions? So here's our plot. Notice we have a plane. It goes through the point where z equals 3, and it's parallel to the xy plane. So in describing the surface, we would call it a plane that is parallel to the xy plane that goes through z equals 3. The next one we're going to look at is x squared minus y equals 0. So we might want to think about what this would look like in the xy plane. We can solve this very easily for y, and we get y equals x squared. Now this is a graph that we're very familiar with. It's just our parabola centered at 0, 0. So the question again, what will this look like in 3D? Well, let's think about adding a z-axis in. And what's going to happen is we're going to have the shape continue in the negative z-direction as well as the positive z-direction. So we'll get still a parabolic shape that has 3 dimensions. Let's take a look at what this one will look like in 3D. So here's our plot looking exactly in the xy plane. And while it can be difficult to see, it does go through 0, 0. It's just not showing up in the plot. What's interesting is when I rotate this, notice we see it going down the z-axis. And that's going to give us that 3rd dimension. So that's what this graph will look like in 3D. The next one we're going to look at is x equals 4. Well, recall what our plot looked like when it was z equals 4. We had a plane parallel to the xy plane through z equals 3. Well, we know this one's going to go through x equals 4. The big question is, what plane will it be parallel to? So let's take a look at the graph. And looking at our graph in the xz plane, we see that we have a line going vertically through 4. If we were to rotate this, we start to see our plane. So there's our plane going through the coordinate x equals 4, and it's going to be parallel to the yz plane. We do want to include that in our description. The last one we're going to look at is y squared minus z squared equals x. This one's a little more complicated than the previous 3. We have all 3 variables in here. So what we might want to do is look at what are called cross sections. We get a cross section by setting a variable equal to 0 and only dealing with 2 variables at a time, so we're only looking at a 2-dimensional plot. So for instance, if we let z be 0, then our graph simplifies down to x equals y squared. So plotting that in the xy plane, we basically get a parabola. It's going to be on its side because it's x equals y squared. We're going to do something similar by setting y equal to 0, and we get x equals negative z squared. Once again, we get a parabola. So again, what does this graph look like in 3D? That's really the big question here. So we have two parabolas, both that we saw had a vertex at the origin. So here's our two parabolas. Now where we have to be careful in thinking about this is if we think about this with our axes, not both parabolas are in the same plane. One was in the XZ plane, but the other was rotated into the XY plane. So we have parabolas that touch at their end but are off by 90 degrees. So we get what's called a saddle type shape. Let's take a look at the 3D plot. So here's our 3D plot, and you can start to see how it looks like a saddle. If we rotate, we see one of our parabolas here. We can see that that's the one in the XZ plane. If I rotate this way, I can see the one that was in the XY plane. So we can see how our two parabolas touch at their vertex, but they're in different planes, so it's as if they're off by 90 degrees. So that's how we can recognize that shape. Now, what we can do is the functions that we've looked at, we can take those to help us identify other functions moving forward.